Breaking tonight, new fallout after President Obama announces he will take to the airwaves at roughly this time tomorrow, outlining a plan to bypass the people's representatives in Congress and suspend the deportations of some 5 million illegal immigrants, all with the stroke of his pen. Welcome to the Kelly File, everyone. I'm Megyn Kelly. At roughly 8 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow night, November 20th, President Obama is scheduled to announce what looks like the most sweeping executive action on immigration in American history. And it is one the president himself has said for years is totally, unambiguously illegal.
The notion that I can just suspend deportations through executive order, that's just not the case, because there are laws on the books that Congress has passed. There are enough laws on the books by Congress that are very clear in terms of how we have to enforce our immigration system, that for me to simply, through executive order, ignore those congressional mandates would not conform with my appropriate role as president.
I can't solve this problem by myself. We're going to have bipartisan support in order to make it happen.
We're also a nation of laws. That's part of our tradition. And so the easy way out is to try to yell and pretend like I can do something by violating our laws.
I can't simply ignore laws that are out there. I've got to work to make sure that they are changed.
I know some here wish that I could just bypass Congress and change the law myself. But that's not how democracy works. See, democracy is hard, but it's right. Changing our laws means doing the hard work of changing minds and changing votes one by one. Sometimes when I talk to immigration advocates, you know, they wish I could just bypass Congress and change the law myself. But that's not how democracy works. Now, I swore an oath to uphold the laws on the books. Now, I know some people want me to bypass Congress and change the laws on my own. Believe me, the idea of doing things on my own is very tempting. I promise you, not just on immigration reform. But that's not how our system works. That's not how our democracy functions. That's not how our Constitution is written.
Not how our Constitution is written. I can't ignore the laws. Democracy is hard, but it's right. Time and time again, he assured the American people he understood his proper role.
The problem is that, I'm the President of the United States. I'm not the Emperor of the United States. My job is to execute laws that are passed. And Congress right now has not changed what I consider to be a broken immigration system. Mm-hmm. And what that means is that we have certain obligations to enforce the laws that are in place, even if we think that in many cases the results may be tragic.
In 2012, the president allowed certain children brought here illegally by their parents to remain. These are the so-called Dreamers. And later, he assured the American people this was the last of his executive orders on this.
We are a nation of immigrants, but we're also a nation of laws. So what I've said is we need to fix a broken immigration system, and I've done everything that I can on my own.
What I have been able to do is to make a legal argument that I think is absolutely right, which is that given the resources we have, we can't do everything that Congress has asked us to do. What we can do is then carve out the DREAM Act folks, saying young people who have basically grown up here are Americans that we should welcome. But if we start broadening that, then essentially I would be ignoring the law in a way that I think would be very difficult to defend legally. So that's not an option.
Today we know he's about to do the very thing he said would flout the law. The very thing he said would be, quote, very difficult to defend legally. And his defenders say, well, he misunderstood the law. For 6 years?
The president may have said that he didn't have the authority, but he obviously hadn't consulted with lawyers or didn't understand that this had been done many, many times for 70 years. The only reason he's doing it now is because he knows it is legal. And so he did his research since those remarks, and clearly he believes that he has the authority to do it.
The constitutional law professor, the president of the United States, who was under enormous pressure to expand the options for illegal immigrants without Congress's help, that man failed to do his research, failed to get proper legal advice. That's what they're going with? Well, let's take him at his word. Let's accept that the 25 times we found on camera of the president saying it was illegal for him to do this were all a big mistake, and that he repeatedly misled the American people because he had a bad lawyer. The problem is, that is not all he said. He went on to describe what bad policy this would be, that it would be unwise, unfair, that it would send the wrong message, and that it could lead to a surge in illegal immigration. But don't take my word for it. Listen.
There are those in the immigrants' rights community who have argued passionately that we should simply provide those who are illegally with legal status, or at least ignore the laws on the books and put an end to deportation until we have better laws. I believe such an indiscriminate approach would be both unwise and unfair. It would suggest to those thinking about coming here illegally that there will be no repercussions for such a decision. And this could lead to a surge in more illegal immigration. And it would also ignore the millions of people around the world who are waiting in line to come here legally. Ultimately, our nation, like all nations, has the right and obligation to control its borders and set laws for residency and citizenship. And no matter how decent they are, no matter their reasons, the 11 million who broke these laws should be held accountable.
And now, with the latest polls showing the American public overwhelmingly opposes this power grab by a lame duck president who is on record as believing this very action would be illegal, he will come to the microphones tomorrow night and tell you he's doing it anyway. Senator Ted Cruz reacts right after this break.